Hello and welcome back to another video with It's Dr. Dan, and today we're going to be learning how to draw Zwitterions, which are different structures for amino acids, and we're going to be looking at them in different pHs. So exactly, let's go through it, let's look at what an amino acid is, and try to understand what the basic idea of a Zwitterion is, and some tips and tricks behind how to draw these for your introductory biochemistry course. So for what we're going to be starting with is just looking at a normal amino acid here. And what we got to realize is that it does not actually exist like this when it is in a physiological condition, meaning when it's in the body, because your body is full of solutions, right? It's essentially we are one giant bag of liquid. So if we were to look at this, right, we have a couple different things we want to label. We have our carboxylic acid side of the amino acid, which is our C terminal. We have our amino acid side, which is on the left hand side. So we have our amino acid that is known as an N terminal. We have our R group as well, which is generally very special for every one of the 20 amino acids that we find in the body. And where that R group is located is on what we call the alpha carbon. So every single amino acid occurs in that order from left to right is an amino acid on the left, on that left-hand side or the left-hand side. And then it goes NCC every time, right? NCC, NCC, as they're bonding in those proteins, right? It's going to make a polypeptide chain. So now what does it mean if it's, how do we look at this in the body? Well, if we have this structure here, what is going to be changing? Well, what do acids and bases do? Well, to kind of review that a little bit, right? Acids donate a proton. So if we have that carboxylic acid side, that is going to donate a proton, and it's going to exist to look a little bit more like this, where we're going to have a negative charge on our carboxylate group. And where's that hydrogen going to go? Well, it needs to go to a base. And where, well, how can we label these two sides? Well, if I have my acid side, you also have your base side, right? Because amines are your organic bases. So when that happens, it will accept that extra proton, which will then give a positive charge on our nitrogen group, a negative charge on our carboxylic group, creating what is known as a Zwitterion. So now Zwitterions have two charges. So one way for you to help remember two charges is you think the word Zwitter has two T's, right? So two T's, two charges. So that was one way a student of mine told me to remember that. And it can stick, right? Those little things help. So two charges. Now, as a result, those two charges are overall neutral, okay? So when we have that neutral charge, because the positive cancels out the negative, that is making an overall zero charge as a result. So we have a zero charge from that when we have those two charges combining together. So keep that in mind, right? Neutral means zero overall. Let's go through this and go through some different examples of how we can apply this, and let's go look at some tips and tricks. Right, tips and tricks for these. These are sometimes the most complicated thing for introductory students to draw because acids and bases are really hard to understand. So one thing we have to realize is that the physiological conditions of your body vary depending on where we are talking about. Every organ has its own unique pH, which breaks down different types of chemicals through metabolism differently. Now, as a result, one way to remember how to draw these is think of how acids and bases behave. Acids donate protons, so meaning that they generally give them away. So what I want you to think of is when we have an acid, think about adding H+. Now, what do? Bases receive a proton. So what does that mean that bases do? They will remove H+ from something. So when we're referring to the different pHs of the physiological body, if we are in a basic or a high pH, we're removing an H+. And if we're in a low pH, then we are going to be adding H+. Okay, so low and high pH. Now, what is that all in respect to? Well, if we have, let's say, a Zwitterion, well, we have to think of How does the amino acid behave? What does it consider a low and high? Well, every amino acid has what is known as an isoelectric point. Now, this is where essentially it will be a Zwitter ion. Every amino acid has its own unique value. Now, for the isoelectric point, generally we label that as pi whenever we are seeing that. So where that Zwitter ion is located, like the one that we have here in the middle of the screen, this is drawn as the Zwitter ion, meaning that the body's pH is equal to its isoelectric point. So how will that structure change if I am to go both ways? So let's think of those tips from above. Remember, add hydrogen, remove hydrogen. So if I go, let's say, on the left-hand side here, let's say if I want to be more acidic, well, what exactly is going to happen to this structure? Well, let's think. So if I am to be at a lower pH, so pH less than the pi, meaning I am acidic, we are going to add hydrogen. So where can you add an H plus? What's the thing that most likely wants to accept an H plus? The negative area, right? So when that happens, right, we're going to add a hydrogen to that negative area. Okay, so we're going to put that right here. Now, as a result, how does the charge change? You can see overall, the charge is equal to plus one as a result. So when that is an acidic condition, we can see that as a plus one. Now, if we want to go the other way, let's say if I want to go basic in this case, well, same idea here, is we're going to be removing H+. So where can you remove H+ from your Zwitter ion? Where is it the easiest to take that away from? Well, as you can see, we have an extra one on that amino group. So what are we going to do? We're going to remove that plus charge, take away a hydrogen, therefore making an ion that is now able to act like a base by removing. So when the pH is greater than the pi, we now have a charge of negative one, which is our structure. Okay, so if you remember with acids and bases, add H plus, remove H plus, it's going to make it a lot easier. So let's take a look at some different examples and see if we can practice this and master this together. Okay, so now in the following example, what are we going to be doing? Well, this says draw the structure of lysine at the following pHs, and the pi is equal to 9.7, meaning that the isoelectric point for this amino acid that's drawn here, this is what is considered to be neutral for that amino acid. So if I have the amino acid here, what exactly would it look like if it was a physiological condition? Well, that is where the Zwitter ion will come into play. So if I am going to have my Zwitter ion, the first thing we got to remember is, remember, acids donate that proton. So now when it does that, we are going to have that negative charge on the O, and that hydrogen is going to be added over to that that H3, and it's going to put a positive charge on our nitrogen. So where can we go first? Let's fill in these different structures. So if I want to go to, let's say, a higher pH, right? So this is considered to be basic conditions. What would essentially happen? So I'm at a pH of 12 here, where the pH is a lot higher than that isoelectric point. So base, removing hydrogen. So where can I remove hydrogen from? The only place that is available is that amino group that is on that side over here. So we can remove it from that location. So if I do that, right, it takes away the charge. And as a result, we have H2N, and that is a basic amino acid. Let's go more acidic. What if you start traveling through the digestive tract and things start to change? So what will we first have is we are now going more acidic. So on these next two, you can see it gets progressively more acidic, meaning that the farther and farther you go, it could start changing more and more throughout the structure. The first place that we are going to be doing acidic conditions is, remember, is adding hydrogen. So where can we add hydrogen first? Well, right directly to the amino backbone, where the amino group, the carboxylic acid group is. So we are going to add a hydrogen to the one place that is possible, and that's going to be right on that carboxylic acid. Being that the amino group already has one, there's no room for you to add one to that location. Now, as this starts getting even more and more acidic, so if I take this thing, is there anywhere else that we can add a hydrogen? And the one thing you're always looking at, are there any amino groups that we can add this to? And if you look at the R group all the way at the bottom that's on both these sides here, this is a basic amino acid, meaning that eventually if you keep lowering that pH, we will add a hydrogen down below with another charge down here. And that is going to once again add a hydrogen into another location. So we can see as it travels from basic to what is considered neutral with the isoelectric point, all the way to acidic, the charges are changing as a result. And we can even write down the charges here, right? We see that goes from negative 1 to neutral to positive 1 to positive 2 overall as we go from one structure to the next to the next. Let's do one more together. So this was a basic example. And the first one that we did together was neutral. Let's take a look at an acidic amino acid. Okay, let's draw the structure of aspartic acid at the following pH, which has a pI of 3.0, which is where it's considered to be neutral for this amino acid. So this is aspartic acid. This is an acidic amino acid. And right here, what I already have drawn for us is a Zwitterion. So let's first go in the acidic direction. So if I were to go to the acidic direction, what can change? Well, remember, acid is add hydrogen, AA, right? If I add hydrogen, where can you add an H plus 2? Well, if we're going to look at these groups, is there anywhere available for us? And the one place you can see is right on that negative charge, right here on that carboxylic acid. So if I add an H plus, we can see the overall charge as a result turns to plus 1 when we do that. So we are adding our hydrogen. Now, what happens if I start going basic? Well, if we start going from one basic molecule to the other, the whole idea is the farther you get basic, where you want to remove hydrogens from the different locations. Now, exam questions and things like that can change depending on how your teacher ends up wording it, right? Sometimes they might just want the final thing. Usually that's what I ask for my students. But everyone, it's always about removing H pluses. So where can I remove H plus first? The first place is that amino backbone, being that we have that positive charge, right? So I'm going to remove one of those hydrogens there. And overall, then we have just a negative 1 charge, right? It goes from plus 1 to neutral to negative 1 overall. Now, where can I remove it on the next one as I keep increasing the pH? Well, not only did I take one off the backbone earlier, but I can also remove one off the carboxylic acid group, which is down here at the bottom, right? We have COOH, and when that happens, we now have a negative ion that is down here, meaning we have an overall charge of 2- as a result, which then shows you how aspartic acid can change to aspartate by removing all those little pieces, right? Because the 8 ending means a salt. So this is how you can go through these. We went through a neutral example, an acidic example, and a basic example of how to draw different amino acids. I hope that this video helped you, and I hope you do well on your homeworks and exams with this. And if you did like this video, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and I hope to see you all in the future. All right, bye now.